Dennis Dash Bridge just went over. It's a nice long hill to go down. this just right. There's a tripod, that's better. Come on, move that car. What's gonna catch you up, but it's gonna be nice.
Guitars and
drums and bass and harmonica. So this guy comes up and one of the guitarists looks up at me and goes, just pay attention to this guy here. I'm like, all right. So then they're like, well, okay, we're going to play this type of song. It's going to be like, do, 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 do. And I'm like, okay. Boom! Started playing. I ended up playing like four songs. And after the second song, you know, there were people dancing and everything. And after the second song, somebody said, this is band four. So here's another song from band four. And we were the fourth group that got together as a band, I guess. And they're like, man, that was pretty good. You played pretty good. I'm like, thanks. It's been a while since I played. When I first signed up, the guy goes, so do you have your own sticks? I'm like, no, I didn't even know you guys did this. But don't worry, if I break it, I have no problem giving you money to replace them. Okay. So, when we got done, the guys I played with, they were kind of like impressed, and I kind of was myself too. But I told them how long it's been since I played. I was surprised myself. I go, it's been 5 years since I've played with a band, played with anybody, since I played the drums, period. 5 years. I thought about that for a second, like, dang, 5 years, it's like quite a bit. But I actually did really well. Yeah, my hands were crimping up a little bit. You can feel it in my palms of my hands. The way I hold the sticks, kind of like out of shape. But the playing was just like riding a bike. Like I hadn't missed a beat in 5 years. No pun intended. But so they go, yeah, we do this every Thursday. Definitely come on back. I go, well, I never know when I'll be in town, but every Thursday, if I'm in town, hell yeah, I'll come over and jam with y'all. I found out one other time out on the highway, I played a couple of times. It was outside of Boise, Idaho. The truck stopped there. They had an open mic night. They did the same kind of thing. And they had their guitars, drum sets set up. People just come up and play. Sign your name up. But this one's nice because it's right in my neighborhood. Like going to Boise, I got to know the people because I was running a pretty regular run. So I was out there quite a bit. So anyway, I thought I'd share that with you because it was a pretty good deal for me. I enjoyed it quite a bit. Originally, when I was fueling up the truck and finishing the paperwork and getting ready to park it, and I could hear music from down the street, which is about a little over, maybe just about a quarter of a mile away. And so it was nice and quiet at night, so I could hear it. So I'm like, well, I'm going to have me a couple beers and listen to some live music. Didn't expect I would be partaking in that. Participating, I guess. But anyway, that guy that came up, he was a really, really good singer. I was impressed. I told him, I go, those are pretty good songs. It's kind of bluesy, rockish, country-ish type music. More towards the blues side. I told him, I go, that's some pretty good tunes you guys were jamming. A drummer, you can just fill in. Of course, they're going to be different than other people, but as long as you keep the tempo and the beat is pretty decent, you can hang with them, which is what happened. Each song had their own tempo and their own beat. So, I don't like it when I play with people and all the beats sound the same. You're only as good sometimes as the people you're playing with. Their guitars always sound the same, the beat's always gonna kind of sound the same as well. You try to break it up, but kind of tough to do sometimes. Now we're coming to Yakima. The local time is 6:45. I think. I'll have to look at my phone. Yeah, 6:45. Seems later than that. So this is a farmland. Thing that sucks for a dry van driver, somebody like myself who doesn't like reefers, doesn't like an APUs that sound like a lawnmower with a broken muffler at 5 a.m. Sunday morning, all night long. I can't stand APUs. And they smell too. But anyway, I only spent the night maybe once, maybe twice at a truck stop here in Yakima. And the only bad thing about it is it's a great truck stop. We've got a restaurant in there pretty good, they got a little bar in there. But every truck is a reefer truck. Every stinking one of them, except for my truck. Now, not all of them, but 98% are reefer. So it's a noisy truck stop. There's a reefer right in front of us right here. You can tell by that little door on the back of the trailer. Not to mention the diamond plate, stainless, helps give it away a bit as well. You see a little hole in the lower fairing right there, that gives it away. Now granted, the newer reefers are quieter. But what I don't like about them is the constant change in RPMs. They're never, like, I can sleep next to a truck that's running, but not a reefer or an APU. APU's the worst, reefer's the second worst. Running truck is the third, but I can deal with the running truck. found this on my passenger seat. It's working pretty good. But not quite the same as a back scratcher. I might have fell down on the passenger floorboard because I thought I had it up on top of the dashboard. Truck stop is right up here. On the right hand side. Got it, a truck brought it. Gear jammer, that's what it is right there, a gear jammer truck stop. It's a pretty good truck stop, but every one's a reefer. Talk to the truck drivers and they're like, I can't sleep without it. He drove too long with it, that's why. More power to you. I wish what they would do is have a, I think they do in England, like, I believe in segregation. If I ever had a big truck stop, I would have reefers over by the freeway. Then you should have a quiet area where worst thing that you could do is idle your engine. You couldn't have an APU, and you can't have a reefer. Oregon, and I went to bed and everything. I was snoring away. I got woken up to the loudest reefer unit in the United States. It had to have been unmuffled, no muffler attached to it. That thing was just freaking loud. The guy had no qualms about parking right next to somebody at 2 o'clock in the morning and letting that thing blare and wake everybody up. I literally was so pissed off, I had to drove my truck forward, did a 360 turn around, and nosed in. So I could have that at my rear end. quick view of Yakima there. So thanks again for riding shotgun. Where I'm driving and you're riding shotgun. Until the next time, y'all take care of yourselves and enjoy. Peace.